Gently meshed together. Focus on deep, relaxed breathing. And today I'd like for you to draw your attention to your dantian, which is that spot just below your navel, and imagining internally a couple of inches. So just, it's not something you can palpate, but just see if you can send your attention there. Feel that area of your body expand and contract with your breath. Out slowly. Be relaxed. When you feel ready, go ahead and transition to embracing horse. section and then looked at details and corrections up through the repeat moves from the second section through the diagonal single wing. Is that correct? Sound familiar?
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's do that third section again, just to kind of lock down sequence. And again, it's warm up. So this is not about necessarily flexing your deepest stances or your hardest work. This is just moving the body a little bit and starting to get reacquainted with the third section if it's been a while since you've done it or first time that you're learning it. Okay. Take a couple deep breaths. Shake out the last vestiges of a long embracing horse if you need to. Start from cross hands. Embrace tiger, return to mountain. Dyad ahead, grasp the bird's tail. Diagonal single lift. Horses made one. Park the wild horses made two. Park the wild horses made three. Grasp the bird's tail. Single width. Four corners. Fair lady work shuttles. One. Fair lady work shuttles. Two. Grasp the bird's tail. Single whip. Snake creeps down. Golden rooster stands on left leg. Golden rooster stands on right leg. couple smokies. One.
Repulse monkeys. Two.
Repulse monkeys. Three. Don't get ahead. Slant, fly. Lift hands. White crane spreads wings. Brush knee push. Needle and seabar. Fan through back. Turn around, white snake spits its tongue. Hidden hand punch. Grasp the bird's tail. Single whip. Transition to cloud hands. Cloud hands one. Cloud hands two. Cloud hands three. Single whip. Pat high horse. Piercing palm. Turn body, cross core kick. Brush knee push. Actually, brush knee push. Punch to groin. That's it. Brush knee punch to groin. And grasp the bird's tail. Single whip. Snake creeps down. Step up seven stars. Step back, ride the tiger to the mountain. Sweep the lotus. Bend bow, shoot tiger. Hidden hand punch. Withdraw and push. Cross hands. Feet together.
Confusing in spots.
Of course. This is your first time through the third section, correct?
Monday night was the first time.
Okay, but this is your first unit through it.
Yes, it is.
Yes, so confused is how I'd expect you to feel.
Lost.
And this doesn't have anything to do with class, I'm just sharing with you. For those of you who don't know it, I do have a connective tissue disorder. So that means my joints are wobbly and they do weird things. So sometimes if it's like, why is Instructor Durkin wobbling? It's because my foot or my ankle decides it's not going to hold me up. So I just like to put that out there. Be like, she's how many stripes? And she's sometimes my joints aren't there for me. So just putting that out there.
You never know this.
Well, my point is, even if I'm wobbling, I can help you get your Tai Chi. It doesn't look like, well, she can't stand on one leg very well. Some days I can, some days it's like, no, not happening. So just a little bit of, I like to pre-frame what the different sections of the form focus on. So first section, everything is on a grid. It's on that 90-degree grid. Second section, it's mostly on that grid, but you start to get some diagonals, right? So you start to move, you know, on these angle deviations from that grid. But then it mostly returns to the grid. Third section, you get the diagonals, but then you also get some weird moves, right? So there's advancing, but in hit the tiger foot placement instead of double dragons. You get that exploring of working corners that you do in four corners. And then of course there's the snake creeps down, the standing on one leg stuff, which we'll get plenty of practice on. And then those crescent kicks, those two crescent kicks. So the complexity of the movements and the ways in which you advance get more complicated in the third section. So that's kind of like there's a crescendo of, you know, super easy, it's on the grid, now you get angles, now you're moving backwards in corners, and then, you know, so it's, that's kind of like, if you can focus on that, that might help you as you progress through. So what I like to see is just, I'm gonna call out the names, it's gonna be the same thing as from the second section. I'd like to see the work that happened on Monday with those first repeat moves, just to see how everyone's doing. So start from cross hands, I'll call names, and I'd like to see it through the grasp bird's tail to the diagonal single whip. And then we'll answer questions and probably advance to part the wild horse's mane. So, thank you. Take a couple deep breaths. It's not a test. And begin. Embrace tiger, return to mountain. Grasp the bird's tail. Diagonal single whip. Square your hips more towards the line. There you go. And then that's probably going to make you want to turn that back toe in just a little bit more. Hip towards me. Shift in the front leg. There you go. Good. Does that feel tight, ropey?
A little bit.
Maybe go that way with the front foot just a little bit more. Better.
Yeah.
Yes. Good. Okay. Release. So again, with the diagonals, it's really easy to get tight ropey with the foot placement. My workaround for that may or may not be helpful. Forget that you're on the diagonal and just do single whip. Surprisingly, it is the same move, but it looks and feels totally different when you start putting it on an angle. But if you just, la la la, I'm here, and I'm gonna do to here. I mean, if you just tell yourself, do single whip, your body knows how to step. If you find, the correction that I gave for Mr. Schwind is single whip in Yang style, not Chen style, but Yang style is hips mostly aligned forward. Now it's not rigid because that makes me lose my tuck, but it's mostly here. So what happens oftentimes is stepping a little long that way and not enough around. So we end up in sort of this, what I call almost like an oblique single whip where I should be facing here, but I'm really here. And what will help me realize that my feet are wrong is if I try to turn my hips to where they go, if this does really terrible, gross things to my knee, it feels not right. So if I'm trying to put my hips here, this foot has to come more this direction. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
So let that help you on any of these kind of like turning, going from one direction to another direction, and you have to kind of step back to get that double dragon's foot placement. Think about the alignment of your waist and your hips, and that will help you correct if your feet are, you know, tight with me. Make sense? Any questions about any of those moves up to that point? Anything you need to see? Are we ready to part some horses' manes? Okay, part the wild horse's mane. First thing, it is not slant flying. Everyone's like, it's the same. No, it's not. Main difference is slant flying, just for comparison, is a punch comes in this way, I sink under the punch, and I lift and I throw them over my shoulder. I mean, over my thigh and my shoulder, that way. So it's not a strike, it's a throw. This one, these are not applications you need to know for your test, your black sash test, but they are advancing strikes. Basically, you know, reverse ridge hands to the side of the neck. So it would be strike, strike, strike. So it kind of looks the same in the end position as slant flying, but it's not. So that's the first thing. Second thing, let's see if I can demonstrate for you, and then we will work on it together. I'm stepping this time to hit the tiger feet. So it's gonna be a little more back and a little less that way. So I'm here in my diagonal single whip, and I'm gonna see jump step in. I'm gonna step back, leading with the heel. It's okay if the ball of my foot touches first. Sometimes ankle flexibility, it just won't allow for it to be like, just heel. But what I'm not doing is I'm not reaching with my toes. Do you see the difference there?
Yes.
So, spoken from someone who used to do that myself. Like, why is my stance wrong? Because you're reaching with your toes. So, see, down step in, lead with the heel, even if, like in my case, the ball of my foot touches first. It's still, I'm leading with my heel. Then, stay on this leg, turn these toes out, shift, lift, and turn. And it's pretty close to here. All right, so let's try just that transition first. Yes, sir.
So how much difference is there in the lift between slant flying and this?
Well,
because they look the same.
They do. They do feel different.
Okay.
I don't know how energetically they feel different. Maybe it's because I know it's the application.
And just think of the application as opposed to throwing somebody.
And actually, in part the wild horse's mane, I am lifting slightly diagonally. Mm-hmm. Slant flying, I'm lifting almost vertically, but I'm turning my waist.
Okay.
See, I'm splitting hairs here, but notice at the end of slant flying, I'm really aligned here. Subtle, but I'm not as full here. So it's
working on it.
What I was saying is when you're first learning these moves, they are going to feel identical. Once you get more experience with them, they are going to feel totally different. So you are right to ask, well, seriously, what is the difference? Well, a little bit, my understanding, slightly more angle. On part of the horse's thing.
Okay.
And a little bit more straight lift and turn torso on slant line.
One's a throw and one's a strike.
That's exactly right. One is a strike and the other one is throw. And it's, I lift my hand straight up while I turn my waist.
Okay.
Which is what makes it look diagonal. Make sense?
Yes,
hair splitting though. I get it. So, let's try that transition from diagonal single whip into part the wild horse's mane. See how we do. There is a little bit of help I can give you if you have trouble stepping all the way around if it hurts your knee in those weird kicks. But let's start with the rhythm then. Okay? Okay, so diagonal single whip. And since if it's new to you, definitely do the sink down step in. If it's old hat, you don't have to sink down step in. But let's sink down, step in, stay on that front leg, step back, leading with the heel. Stay on this left leg, turn the right toes out, then shift to the right, lift the left, the right hand, turn to the right, turn the left toes in. Same thing, Ms. Garcia, a little bit more that way. Of the forward foot on a line with the toe of the back foot. That way. Closer to you, more that way. And then that way. Yes. Let's try it a couple more times. Yes, sir.
Is the right hand in this, since it's a strike, is it coming up and out a bit?
It's...
You know, the thing would have to be back.
I mean, it's... In Kung Fu, this move is beauty looks in the mirror. I mean, it's, you know, so it's a hand here. But it's... I'm not really turning it out. I'm turning my waist, so I'm...
Oh, okay, so come up and turn your waist.
Yes, I know. Waist turning in Tai Chi, who knew? I've never heard of this concept.
Let me write that down.
Waist turning in Tai Chi. All right, let's try it from diagonal single whip a few times. Thank you. All right, part of the wild horse's main one. Sink down, step in, step back, leading with the toes. Stay on that left leg so you can turn out the right toes, and yes, you should feel like you're going to fall over now. Shift to the right. Lift the hand, turn to the right, turn the left toes in.
So you have to do this?
You do. But it's not. So the question was,
divorce in my head.
Do you do this? Yes, you do. Am I telling myself? No.
Okay.
They pass. So. But they do pass. Right now, I'm focusing on feet. But yes.
Okay, so you just lift your hand up and your waist brings it around.
For the most part, yes. Yes, very nice.
Is this correct foot?
That looks good. Yes. That looks good. Try it two more times together. And begin. That's a lot of horses' mane.
Bring the hand up first, turn first, or they both come up together.
You want to see it again?
Yes, ma'am. Not sure I'll get it, but I'd like to see it.
Oh, no. I'm learning Master Gohring's tried and true way of, if anybody has a question about anything, you want to see it again? Yeah. you needed there?
Yes, ma'am.
So, the way to not is to sink. So I sink here. I don't expect you to hang out here like this, but if you sink, then you lift and split. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am. Just have to remember to do it.
I know. Take a couple minutes, practice this on your own, lock it in a couple times, and then we'll at least look at the transition into the first one, the second one. So the first kind of rock back and how you step into the front wall versus main two. So, just a minute or two.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm trying not to step in, to take that out. So I know when you step in, then you kind of step back. So I'm having a hard time figuring out how to.
Good question. It resets a little bit.
Okay, so bring the foot in a little bit.
Yeah.
And then go straight back.
It's sort of an arc.
Yeah, that was good. Is that good? That was okay.
Okay.
It's not.
Yeah.
So that was fine. Does that make sense though? It's just a little bit.
So my hips are here?
For the most part, yes.
Very good.
Yes.
Do both the feet go at the same time?
No.
No. That makes it. Tight rope, isn't it?
But just that split second, yes, yes.
But sinking does really help.
It does help. If you, if anyone has trouble with that left knee on this as you're trying to step back, let me know, because there is a little thing that we can do to help. Better, yes, yes, very good.
It'd be easier probably to go a little bit faster, but I kind of get.
That's okay, you can go fast to go slow. It's all right. The only thing I would correct is the splitting happens as you start to come up. It's not like a deer and then my hands come. Yeah, your hands, your split was a little bit lagging. That's super splitting hairs, but you're. Yes, there it is. Yes. Yes, sir. Tigers and shooting. I mean, the poor tiger gets it real bad. Anyway, So we just have a minute or two, but let's do that and then we'll talk our way through front of all versus main two. And the good news is if you do front of all versus main two, it's the same to get into front of all versus main three. So diagonal single whip. And park the wild horse's main one. And from here, you're going to rock back, pivoting on the right heel, form a circle with the hands, right hand on top. So your toes should be up. And then you're going to shift into that right leg, sink down, step in. Now you're going to step out. Remember trying to go for, hit the tiger feet, so out, not forward. And then shift to the left, lift the hands, turn the right toes in. And then for fun, let's just wrap it up. Rock back, pivot on the left heel, form a circle with the hands, left hand on top. Sink down, step in. Step out, double dragons. Shift to the right, lift the hands, turn to the right, turn the left toes in. Yeah? Release. We'll work on the long one next class. Yeah. Any last minute questions about horses' manes in the non-horsemanship kind of way? Like, I'm not your go-to for tack and like how you. That was a long time ago. All right. Am I correct that it was snake?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So, the path of self-mastery requires persistent action. Persistent action achieves a goal without quitting. Path of self-mastery requires persistent action. Persistent action achieves a goal without quitting. One more time. The path of self-mastery requires persistent action. Step back with the left. Draw the arms in. Persistent action. Oh, now I've lost my... Achieves, bow stance, a goal without quitting. It's hard to do slow. From the front, one time for the camera. So, persistent action achieves a goal without quitting. And when you put it together, it's... But the most important thing is feet in, change feet, and then your hands do something. So that's the... We'll keep working on it.